deeper about your character. Are you going to be? I play Gale again, and you know, I don't. There's very little that we're allowed to really talk about it. I think the trailer came out. It has some of the characters and people in it, and it was a long time in the making. And it was, you know, it's a movie I did about 25, and I was like, dude, like, I don't know how much longer I'm holding out for this sequel. I don't know how much longer I can wear any of these outfits. So it's good. It was really fun to work again with Frank and Robert and see a lot of the crew and the cast again, because they're all the same people mostly. And, you know, we really miss Brittany. We really miss Michael Clark Duncan. It's really too bad that we couldn't film this with them, because they would have been in it. And, you know, I'm glad that people are still interested in it. You know, it was really fun. It was one of the first comic book adaptation movies ever, and it was really ahead of its time then. And I think, you know, he has some really cool ideas of what he wanted to do and why it would be worth making a sequel. So hopefully people dig it.
But I think that this movie is somehow what you can imagine. So which is the difference between the first one and the one?
They have very similar, actually, because you're shooting on the same stage. I have to say things have gotten a lot easier and technology-wise. So we didn't, you know, we were always shooting, you know, it's like basically that's the set, and you're always shooting this way. So if you needed to get it over, we had to switch. And it was really fascinating, and we had to do a lot to kind of make sure all the placements were done. And it was really advanced then, but now it was even that much more seamless. It was like, hey, yeah, we just got green there, you're fine. And you're like, you don't need to set it. And they're like, no, we're ready to shoot. And you're like, okay, wow. So like the technology's really kind of just, it just made it easier, but it felt very much like the same experience.
And to me, working with two directors, and the other is difficult. What can you tell me about them?
Yeah, it was really cool. I know that Robert had in his DGA card so that he could direct the first one with Frank. Because literally frame for frame, shot for shot, is what he drew. The angles, everything was done. We would be filming, and he'd have an outline of our characters and go, okay, move her a little bit more to the right, a little bit, okay, raise your arm like this, so that we could literally be in the exact framing and poses as he drew them. So Frank was beside himself to see his characters come to life that he drew by himself in the dark, like, you know, like some weirdo. And then here's someone making a movie, and, you know, and I thought that was just really great, because Robert's like, I'm a director, I'm a writer, I'm an editor, I'm a musician, I can do all of it. But this whole vision, the whole look of it, the whole style of it, the shots, the angles, everything is based off of Frank. I'm basically plagiarizing him. If I don't give him credit for directing this, then I don't know what to say. So he actually was going to make it just Frank. At one point he said, don't even put my name on it. Frank insisted. So I think it was a really cool collaboration.